Then don't complain when the world looks at you just as a girl. You've got to grow from a girl to a woman. And in his exact words, and I think if he was still here, he would be clapping the loudest, because he taught me that situations are like a wall. And you take your knuckle to the wall, and your knuckle fears just the air that comes closer as you're about to connect. It fears it. But if you keep going, and you keep that consistent practice in place, there comes a day when the wall fears the knuckle. And in my life, that is the concept of I am. Is to say, I will live my life with dignity, but the conditionings won't apply. Will I have to pay a big price for it? Sure. My life is anything but normal. Every day there is a new question, there is a new situation. But let's be honest, as women, now I'm being gender specific, we are born with this innate ability to process life, not just give birth or nurture alone, but to process it. Somewhere along the way, once the umbilical cord is cut, we kind of think that we've lost that ability. No, it's always there. Ask me, it's even there after menopause. Everything in life is possible. I believe that when you attach something to this I am, including this fabulous line here, woman, it kind of spells the basics of who you are. And it's a fantastic feeling to live that life as honestly as possible. And Karen, that is Alisa, and she's not very fond of the word adopted, not because she doesn't know the word, but yeah, she knows it. And she also tells you the opposite of adopted. Biological, very boring, everyone's born from the stomach, right? She's born from my heart. And boy, what a beauty she is. Thank you for coming in. Sir.
So Shweta, one last thing. What advice would you give our young women? How would you tell them to live their life on their own terms?
Yes, how? I should be publishing a book on this or something. Maybe I should actually, it's a cool idea. Yeah, no, but just got it. Thank you. Breaking inertia, that's what I would call it. It really is, there's no method to this madness. Each of our lives are as unique as our DNAs. For me to tell you how I did it is a waste of your time. Because your situations are different, your life choices are different, your conditioning is different than mine. But one thing that is true and common in all of us, I don't think I should use bad words, but when shit hits the roof, there's sometimes you have to express it like that. Otherwise you don't get the feel of it. But when it comes to that, you got that, right?
Yes.
When it comes to that, I have not known a single woman, whether she belongs to the modern society as we know it, or coming from a rural backdrop, who has not stood up and created a hell of a storm. I have never seen it happen. I have seen an 85-year-old grandmother stand up. And that's who you really are. So, if you want to live your life on your own terms, fasten your seatbelts, take a deep breath, and have the ability to hold on to that breath for as long as you can. Because if you hold on to fear long enough, it turns to courage. It always turns to courage. And when it does, rejection turns to acceptance. The problem is we give up very quickly. The problem is we try a new face cream every day and say it's not working in a week. You have to be consistent. Everything in life is about consistency. So, whatever you choose to be a housewife, be the best housewife anybody can ever be. Because I tell you from my own experience, it is the hardest job in the world. And I have housewife, mother, father, a professional, an entrepreneur, and a person who belongs to other people as part of my job profile. And if I can compartmentalize all of it, and say, if I'm going to do this, I'm going to do just this and do it well. It's incredible what you can achieve in your life. So yeah, by all means. Actually, that's a great thing. A lot of the times people wonder, you don't do movies. I'm a daughter. I must tell you this. Please refrain from laughing, because I couldn't stop laughing when I heard it. So I stopped doing films when she came into my life, because I'd miss out on a lot of Renee's firsts as a mother. And I deeply thought it impacted her growing up years. I didn't want to miss out with Elisa, so I took a break. And that break was amazing, because there isn't a thing about this little one that I have missed. Cut to, she grows up. She's got a very lovely vocabulary, very expressive. And she says to me, why do people take your pictures and your videos and all the time? And so I said, because you know, I'm kind of famous. Doing what? So I said, well, you know, I was Miss Universe. That was a long time ago. That's true, very true. I did create history. Yeah, that was also a long time ago.
True.
But I'm also an actress. Oh, I've never seen you shoot a movie. She had a point. And it is the most thankless job in the world to be a mother. But at the end of the day, I know that when she uses a big word and she expresses herself with ultimatum, for example, she's trying to say ultimatum, but never mind. I see that I achieved that, and for me, these are the little things, including all of my vocational achievements, that cumulatively form the success story of my life. It was any one thing, that's not who I am. There are people made like that, and Lord bless them because they're dedicated to it. For me, it's all these different chapters, and this one is a very big chapter in my life. So yeah. So are you going to sing now, or are you going to sing after giving me an award?
Are you really serious?
No, I'm always very serious.
Look, no recording, no laughing at me.
All of you, zoom in.
So, I do like Bollywood. When we go out partying in the nights, people are like, oh, you live in South Mumbai, you want to hear like the latest club music. And I'm like, no, I want Bollywood. People are like, I'm like, no, I like Bollywood. So there's this one song, which I really like. It's Shweta's in it. I'm going to try. Okay?
Isn't he an excellent taste?
Ajana chule meri chunri sanam, kuch na main bolu chale meri kasam. Hai jawani sar pe mere, tere pe kar jawani tere. Hai.
Before that happens, have the other ladies' recipients received theirs already?
No, we're going to.
Oh, not yet, right? Well, congratulations to all of you. To all of you present here. It's awesome that all of you made the time to come here and applaud all of us women. Because it, you know, you may think we're used to it, but a note of encouragement in our lives goes a long way in furthering the inspiration. So thank you very much for everything.
We are here on wonderful stage. The man who's behind Iron Woman, the man who gives me courage and puts me on the right path, the editor of Youth Incorporated magazine, Nitish Shah. And to be pleased, our most beautiful Alicia join us.
One more thing, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure that you know of... I'm not trying to embarrass you again. I'm just trying to say something I really wanted to say. In all my emotional talking, I forgot to say it. I'm very, very proud of him. One of the biggest reasons for, more than the award, to be honest with you, that I wanted to be here this evening was because he and the Education Foundation of Karan Gupta has impacted enormous amounts of lives. I also have a foundation which deals with educating kids and looking into their health and sanitation. And there's nothing more empowering than education, you've heard that. But you know why? Because it gives you hope. And without hope, there's no way forward. So 92,000 kids, that's the number of lives this foundation has touched in various ways. Yes, must applaud it. Yes. From slum children in Dharavi to just children who need motivation to further their cause, Karan Gupta Education Foundation has my salute for the effort that they continue to put in, not just for women empowerment, but for the most favorite people I have in my life, children. So my hat's off to you, love. More power to you and your team. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. I love you.
Thank you, guys.
Message for youth and women of the
Oh, thank you. Yeah, I need this. Sorry. Just need this desperately because I've been eating my lipstick.
Madam, mic
ready?
Audio, come.
Just keep it here, It'll come.
Of course you can. Babu, I'll just run. Where's Anita? Oh, she got it. Okay, guys. So this is my award, and this is very, very precious. The I Am connection and, of course, the pride I feel in being a woman. And this, like I said, coming from an organization like Karan Gupta Education Foundation has made it very, very memorable for me. And the fact that my daughter was on stage, Alisa, to receive it with me is forever etched in my heart. My message to women in general, you asked me about my message to women.
Women and youth.
You know, it's a very done to death statement and sentiment when they keep saying children are the future, the youth have the world, the power of their hand, they have to decide the way forward. But as repeated and mechanical as that sounds, it is the truth. It is the truth because the choices you're making today, and you're making it in a time when you're not an 18-year-old like me who didn't have Google and YouTube and the social media. The world is open to you even if you haven't traveled to the rest of the world. You know what's happening in the world. You must know that your life matters. Your voice matters. Your opinions are going to shape the way things move forward. So make it look good, but don't lose yourself in social media and social structuring. Find who you are and then get out there and change it. If there's something you don't like, only you can change it. So get out there and change it. Love you guys. Thank
Karan,
you.
Karan, it turned out to be a beautiful program. What are your thoughts?
I think we're very lucky to have Ms. Sushmita Sen with us. She is indeed not only Miss Universe and the most beautiful woman in the universe, she has a golden heart. She is a woman of inner beauty, a woman of courage, a woman of strength, and a woman who makes a difference. Her I Am Foundation and Sushmita Sen, I believe, are going to change the world with all the initiatives that we are doing. So we are lucky again to have Ms. Sen. Thank you so much for being here. You are
very,
our
very
I Am
kind.
woman of substance of the year.
Yeah,
thank you.
And proudly so. Thank you, guys. Yes, come this way. I love you very, very much, and this is cherished.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah,
you're free. Yeah, solo.
मैं बहुत एक्साइटेड हूँ क्योंकि जैसे आप जानते हैं ये जो टॉपिक है एम्पावरमेंट वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट मेरे लिए बहुत स्पेशल है बिकॉज एक्चुअली आई फील वेरी सैड कि आज हम इस चीज़ के बारे में बहुत ज़्यादा बात करते हैं जैसे वुमेन्स एम्पावरमेंट कि वी आर इन अ प्लेस टुडे दैट इट हैज़ टू बी टॉक्ड एंड वी हैव टू बी मेड अवेयर एंड वी हैव टू मेक अवेयर पीपल अवेयर I feel really little sad because we have to celebrate being alive. We have to celebrate the triumph of the human spirit. But ये जब हम कहते हैं women's empowerment ऐसा लगता है कि हम अलग ही species हैं, you know, men or women separate हो गए हैं. So I don't like to use women's empowerment. I like to say empowerment. We have to empower ourselves as human beings and rise above all the challenges. तो ये सारी जो बातें actually I know some of the people who are being honored today. I'm very excited to meet them and I'm going to be talking to few of them. So mujhe aisa lagta hai ki this will inspire all of us, it will inspire me and that is the purpose of this evening. So I'm really looking forward to it.
Mary,
many girls from this small town, you know, aspire to become actress.
I'm sorry?
Many girls from this small town aspire to become actress in the industry. So what is the challenge they basically face, and you know, is the challenge bigger than other industries when you...
You see, it's a very difficult question, and I want to be as honest as I can be. You want to be an actress, anybody can be an actress. That's what we would like to say. कि जो आप ड्रीम करते हैं, जो आप करना चाहते हैं, वो सारे लोग कहाँ से भी हों, वी कैन डू, वी हैव सच एग्जांपल्स, एंड यू जस्ट हैव टू हैव योर ड्रीम स्ट्रॉन्गर, यू हैव टू वर्क हार्ड, एंड आई डू बिलीव दैट ग्रेस ऑफ हैंड, यू नो, द गॉड्स ग्रेस ऑलवेज वर्क्स, सो प्रेयर, वर्क हार्ड एंड ड्रीम बिग एंड अचीव एवरीथिंग.
And Karan Gupta Foundation is supporting the event as such, which looks after the unprivileged children, you know, educate them. What do you have to say about the foundation?
Actually, women's empowerment, aapne ye kai baar suna hoga ki we need more men who are supporting women and calling it women's empowerment. We need men to support women, and I really appreciate and celebrate people like Karan who has created this foundation and initiative and a platform like this where he is celebrating women. And so men like him should be celebrated, and I really congratulate him on this endeavor.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
He doesn't show.
The left.
So you, center. I want from you also.
Yeah.
You want to take a picture?
Left, sir. Yeah.
So you, center.
One more left. Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Ma'am, left.
Ma'am,
you have lipstick
on my lip, do I?
No.
I just put it.
You have to ask
ma'am. Ma'am,
straight.
Yeah. Now you're okay. Right side. Now you're right side. Anyone here?
बस आज ही की शाम सही जा रहे थे आप, बिल्कुल सही जा रहे थे, फिर थोड़ी गड़बड़ होगी, नेवर माइंड, डिडंट मीन दैट.
Can you come this side, please?
This side?
Yeah. Okay.
देखिए आई थिंक जहाँ तक एक औरत होने का दर्जा है मेरे लिए वो अवार्ड मेरा भगवान मुझे बहुत पहले दे चुका है. आई थिंक द फैक्ट दैट आई एम बॉर्न अ वुमन इन इटसेल्फ इज अ ह्यूज अवार्ड इन माय लाइफ. एंड देन टू हैव एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन लाइक करण गुप्ता एजुकेशन फाउंडेशन which holds this very prestigious and inspiring lot of awards for women, recognizing them from different fields. And they're just pioneers and women who inspire the way forward for generations. For them to give me an award, it just feels lovely because they've named it I Am Woman. And I'm a big believer of the concept of I Am. So it's a lovely connect. I'm very, very privileged and honored that they thought of me.
And, हम हिंदुस्तान के ढेरों सारे जगहों पर देखते हैं कि वुमेन के अचीवमेंट की बात होती है, लेकिन कुछ एक जगहों पर बहुत सारी रेप जैसी खबरें भी आती हैं. तो इन सारी चीज़ों को जब आप सुनती हैं, पढ़ती हैं, तो क्या टेक होता है आपका?
मैंने इसीलिए इस बारे में बहुत वक्त से टेक देना बंद कर दिया है, बिकॉज क्या होता है, हम लोग बहुत आवाज़ उठाते हैं, बातें करते हैं, फिर कुछ होता नहीं है. सो इट्स बेटर टू गो थ्रू चैनल्स विच हेल्प लाइक द चेंज ऑग. वी पार्टिसिपेटेड. जब मैं बोलती हूँ मैंने पार्टिसिपेट किया, मैंने, मेरी बेटियों ने, सब ने उस एप्लीकेशन पे साइन किया ताकि गवर्नमेंट तक बात पहुँचे. देखिए दुनिया भर में, हमारे देश में भी बहुत अनफेयर अनजस्ट चीज़ें होती हैं औरतों के साथ, और ये नई बात नहीं है. लेकिन उसके आगे आप दो चीज़ें कर सकते हैं, या तो बुरा फील करके बात को वहाँ छोड़ सकते हैं कि क्या हो रहा है हमारे देश में, ये औरतों के साथ क्या हो रहा है, वी फील वेरी बैड एंड फॉरगेट अबाउट इट, हेडलाइंस चेंजेस, न्यूज़ चेंजेस. या आप मिसाल सामने लाइए, एक ऐसी मिसाल जिसे लोग देख कर कहें ये कर सकती है, मैं कर सकती हूँ. ऐसे आदमी हैं हमारे देश में जो औरतों की मदद करते हैं, वो कर सकते हैं, हम कर सकते हैं. तो दैट इज़ इन योर हैंड, एंड दैट्स वाई आई डोंट टॉक सो मच अबाउट इट, आई रादर डू. And that's what I'm trying to do, and that's what we're trying to do here today as well, is to set some powerful examples, and I'm hoping that that helps
Sushmita,
in the right direction.
Happy evening to you.
I was wondering where you are. Can I just give him a hug? It's been a while.
I know.
Sorry, but
we have to go.
The whole audience is
we'll come back. Question. We'll come back. We'll
go and come back.
Yes. Baka? Yes.
This is such an understanding. Love you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I know you're supposed to speak first, but Rahani, yeah? Hello, everyone. At the... Bye. You guys have taken your shots, no? Outside? No? You guys, thank you very much for this very warm welcome and this very room full of affectionate women. I tell you, there is no greater award than to walk into a room and feel this vibe that you belong to every single person in the room, men and women alike. And to have an award here, that is instituted by a man to celebrate a woman. I think we're living in the right times, in the most celebratory era ever possible. Karan, thank you so much for having me.
Sushmita said, yay! All right, my time moment is over.
No, it's not.
No, it's not.
Because I'm going to make him sing later. Wow. You guys don't know he sings. Do you know he sings? Yeah, because I know this from the flight we took last time together, and he's a man of his word. He said to me, I do this awards, you have to be a part of it, and you know, this is to inspire women. And then I got to know that he also sings, and that's part of the inspiration that he brings into a woman's life. I will have you share this moment later.
There was turbulence on that flight, she didn't hear her right, but okay.
I remember
back
then. I don't know where she went, Miss
Universe. She was managers.
Yeah, but Karan, we'll come back to this, but no, that was the last thing I would tell you this girl can win Miss Universe. Like the last thing.
And then, over the years, I saw the interview. I saw the I Am Foundation. I saw the work that she does supporting other foundations. I saw the work that she does with women and children. I saw that she adopted children to make a family complete. I mean, what more can we ask for? So clearly, I saw the inner beauty, and that is the reason why we have, of course, here Sushmita Sen, the woman of substance. All right, everyone just wants to hear from you and not me. So Sushmita, please tell us about your journey as a woman.
please take your time. Darling, how was the rush? I have to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, of course, I'll tell you. The question you're asking is my journey as a woman. How's it been? Well, my journey period has been a very exciting and a very enlightening one. But I would not say it's been so, or define it as the journey of a woman, because if that were true, and I have not chosen to live my life not on the basis of a gender, I doubt I would have made the decisions or lived the life the way the one that I do. Because there are too many preconceived notions and ideologies attached to what it is to be a woman and to live the life of a woman. And it's enough for me to be a human being. And it's not to fight for equality, because so God help me, I've never stood up and said, we must fight for women equality, because then I'm accepting as a woman we're not equal. So we already have a problem there. Of course there are facts, and of course there are circumstances around us, there's a social conditioning, which has to change. But that's a mindset. That's not how we're born. So what makes all of this journey so incredible is that while other people speak of their achievements in their vocational capacity, or the social causes they attach themselves to, or just the husband they married, or, you know, the universities their children go to. Great. But I kind of think my life's greatest achievement is that I understood that everything has a source from which the journey begins and the journey culminates. And that to me is I am. It is understanding that no matter what choices you make or the relationships you have with your work, with people, with friends, with colleagues, with your family, is second to first understanding who you are. And who is that person doing all of these things? Because if you don't know that person, you will always be dictated by everyone else. How to be a good girl, how to be a good wife, how to be the right CEO for a company, because you're a woman. Or just simply the choices that you need to make so that you are more acceptable. That's been my life's greatest achievement. And I brought Alisa here today, my younger daughter, because the elder one is busier than I am. And so the younger one's come with me because she said, I want to see you get an award and I want to stand on the stage with you when that happens. So I told her, I said, darling, you have a deal. You can come with me, but to achieve an award, to achieve a place in the world where you deserve an award, you must know that feeling from within you. You must not come up as my daughter. I would like to come up on stage one day as your mother. Oh. And that would be a high. My journey, ladies and gentlemen, has been a fantastic one. I have known great highs and terrible lows. I have had the privilege of making brilliant mistakes. And I kid you not, what makes it so fantastic is the day I decided that, hey, I'm always going to make mistakes. It's part of being human. But I'm going to make new ones. I'm not going to repeat the old ones. Yeah, it worked. It worked. I'm not going to allow the concept of beauty and life be defined by someone else. Because God knows if you give them that freedom, they will define it for you. My grandfather, Papi Dadu, he would tell me that, you know, Titan, if you ever turn around, even to get your way manipulated into something, you might end up saying, but what can I do about this? You know, I'm just a girl. Which, by the way, we know how to use this line so well sometimes. But he said, the problem with that sentence